I'm Carter.
I'm Avery.
Today we will be talking about a Ted Bundy movie called
Extremely Wicked, Shockingly Evil, and Vile.
And basically the movie just goes around Ted Bundy's whole journey of
being a serial killer.
And goes through his thought process and this trial.
It stars Zac Efron and Lily Collins, and it's really good.
It's on Netflix, right?
Yeah.
So if you haven't seen it, you should totally go watch it.
10 out of 10.
Very, very good movie. 10 out of 10. 5 stars.
I watched it the other day.
I don't even know how it starts.
Okay, well, if you don't know who Ted Bundy is, he's a serial killer. He killed, 40-some women
all across
like
the U.S.
that they know. That's what he confessed to.
All around the U.S.
It's probably more.
Yeah, probably. He traveled around in a little
yellow.
Volkswagen bug.
I think that's what it's called.
Yeah.
And he was creepy. He did things to women.
He did very
bad,
very bad things.
One of them, murder.
Like, kill them.
was at the Chi Omega sorority house. These two girls, went back to their sorority house, and he, hit them over the head and, did things to one of them, for sure. And, then, killed them.
So how he did most of his murders was he would, lure the woman.
Because he was a very attractive guy.
Yes, he was very
attractive. Especially, in that time. He was handsome.
And he used that charm and charisma to lure these women to murder them.
Yeah.
And he had a girlfriend.
Oh, yeah.
The whole time. Who had a daughter.
Yep. Daughter's name was Molly. I don't remember the girlfriend's name.
I don't remember the girlfriend's name, but the daughter's name was Molly.
Yeah.
And
the girlfriend's played by Lily Collins, by the way.
And, he was a great guy to her.
And, her daughter.
And her daughter.
They met, at least in the movie, they met at, a bar. And,
he asked her to dance, right?
Yeah. And then they, he took her home and she invited him in and,
It just, he was two different people with her and
the woman he murdered. Yeah, in the movie, when he's with his girlfriend and, her daughter, he's a great guy.
He's very kind and caring.
Yeah, he's a father
figure. Yeah, he's more of a, he's definitely a father figure to the daughter.
Husband material.
But
then he goes and he travels because he's trying to become a lawyer. So he goes places and whatever, and he kills people.
And because he was becoming a lawyer, he was very smart and he knew a lot of things with the law. So that's what stopped him from being caught for such a long time.
Yeah, and then when he was in his trial and stuff, I don't know if this is how it went in real life because I wasn't alive, but in the movie, he fires his lawyer and becomes his own lawyer.
Because he thinks he can do a better job.
And he didn't because he got death by the electric chair, and they don't know if this is true, but at the end of the movie, it said that it might have been a woman who was the one who killed him in the electric chair or whatever. So
kind of get back in him.
Yeah, and they showed videos, real videos at the end of the movie after they came out and was yeah, he's dead now. Everybody was celebrating and stuff. He killed a lot of girls.
And he didn't just kill them, he tortured them and did a lot of gruesome things to these women.
Yeah, it was horrible.
Mm-hmm.
Look up picture. No, I'm kidding.
Don't look up pictures. He had a lot of hatred towards these women.
For like, no reason.
For who knows why.
Like, it was just because he was a psychopath.
Yeah. He had a lot of issues of his own.
Yes.
So. Don't talk to strangers.
Well, I mean, just don't be overly trusting with them.
Don't get in a stranger's car.
Yeah, especially if it's
a Volkswagen.
And it's yellow. Don't get in a yellow car.
And their name is Ted.
Last name Bundy.
Even though he's dead. Yeah, especially if they're attractive.
If they're attractive and being, like, creepy to you,
it's probably red flag. A psychopath. Red flag.
If this attractive person's saying creepy things to you, just, like,
there's probably something mentally wrong with them.
They will hurt you. Probably.
Probably. 9 times out of 10.
Or they want to hurt you, so don't trust them. So. Yeah. Avery, do you watch a lot of serial killer documentaries?
I really don't. Like, I don't watch TV that much.
Okay. I do. I like watching documentaries on true crime. Right now I'm actually watching one on the Night Stalker.
In
LA.
Yeah,
I haven't watched it all yet. I'm on the second or third episode. It's very good so far. Yeah. I like kind of getting like the documentary view where they kind of go into a more personal with people who knew this person.
Yeah.
And after a lot of serial killers are like caught, most of the people that they know are like, oh my god,
I never expected that. They're really good at
faking. Yeah, they're like a really nice person. Like, they're so kind. Yeah. Like,
it's not like a serial killer is gonna like
act like a serial killer.
Like, psychopath in front of everybody.
Yeah, they're very good
They're usually like a normal guy who you'd like be like
trusting
enough.
Like, friends like, with. Like, look at your neighbor now. Like, you're probably not like, they're definitely a serial killer. But like, you never know. I'm not saying anyone's neighbor is a serial killer, especially around here, but...
But, like, she's just saying, you just don't know.
Mm-hmm. You never know.
So, yeah. Also on Netflix, the Ted Bundy tapes, have you ever watched those?
Yes, I have watched the Ted Bundy tapes.
I watched those when I was, like, sleeping with the flu at my grandma's house. We watched all the episodes in one day. It was really good.
Yeah.
It's, like, real life, like, interviews with Ted Bundy. Like, it's all... actual
like
stuff.
Recordings of what he said, and
he's like a creep though.
Mm-hmm.
Like, really though, he's not even that attractive to me.
Same.
But like back in that time, I guess he was.
Mm-hmm. He was considered very attractive.
But part of it's that he's like in prison, so he looks like a psychopath. Like, his hair is crazy.
Yeah, and it's like after he did get like caught and convicted of all these crimes, then he like really let his true self out. And
he was
like
kind of a smart aleck. Like,
yeah.
Like the
reporters
and stuff.
Mm-hmm. He's very.
He was trying to be funny,
but
like,
it just was.
It was
creepy.
It was creepy.
Yeah.
But yeah, I like the Ted Bundy tapes probably more than the movie. Just because it's real.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen the movie 22nd July?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think I have.
It's like this camp in Norway. And there's like a bunch of like 14, 15, 16 like year olds.
Like
there.
Teenagers.
And it's like a church camp.
I think it's like something. A retreat of some sort.
Something. But there's like a bunch of kids there.
Is the audio working?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Anyways,
as I was saying, Cambry.
Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
So, yeah, these kids are at this island, and there's, like, this guy. He's, like, he's not a cop, but he's, like, pretending to, like, be one. Because he, like, has different beliefs than, like, these kids from what they're doing. And in Norway, he, like, drops this bomb off in, like, this white van.
he puts a bomb in like a big tower, something like an important building. So then like all the cops are like there checking out the bomb and making sure people are okay and stuff.
Yeah, it explodes. And then he goes to the island and he's dressed up as like a sheriff basically.
Mm-hmm.
And he's on this boat and he's like talking to like the counselors or something, that the people are there. And he's like, yeah, I'm just here to like make sure everything's like okay and whatever. And they're like, yeah, okay. So then he goes over with them and then he like shoots the two people that let him come over. And then he like shot up the camp of like all the kids.
And he like and killed a bunch of the kids, and it was based off a true story also.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Like that actually happened.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, and then like this one kid, he got like shot in his leg.
Yeah,
or something. And he was like paralyzed.
Yeah, the main characters are these two brothers who kind of, it revolves around them. Mostly in their parents. It kind of tells from their point of view. I think they both survive.
Yeah, and like the one guy who got shot, he had to like learn physical therapy
mm-hmm.
and stuff, and like learn how to
walk. Through a bunch of stuff because of it. Yeah, it's a really sad movie. I cry every single time that I watch it.
Oh my gosh, my favorite movie. It's so sad. The Fault in Our Stars.
That's like totally different.
I know.
Like that's a completely different topic. Like,
I know.
But yeah, it's very
one
sad.
One of my favorite movies ever.
I haven't even seen it.
Oh. It's so good. You should watch it. It's like about two kids
who are both terminally ill.
Yeah, they meet at like
support group.
Yeah. That so the main characters Hazel and Gus. And they like meet at support group and they fall in love.
And then he dies.
Yeah. He dies because he has cancer all over.
But, like, he had a Make-A-Wish left, and she really wanted to go to...
She wanted to meet this, like, author.
This author who wrote her favorite book, because it ended weird, and she wanted to know what happened after the ending.
Yeah.
So,
like
Gus used his Make-A-Wish to take her there on this trip with
because
her mom.
Her first one she used to go to Disney World.
Yeah, which he made fun of her. But then he used his Make-A-Wish on her. And they went and they met this author and it went south because the author
was not a very nice guy.
Not
he was
they,
drunk
yep,
all the time.
Because
his daughter
died. He was an alcoholic.
Died. His daughter died.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why he was sent off.
So don't meet your idols.
Yeah. But
they're never who you expect.
It's such
but
a
then
good movie.
But then the kid dies and she's really sad.
It, the ending is so sad because, see, he writes, so Hazel wanted Gus to write her eulogy to be read at her funeral, but then when she found out that Gus was dying, she had to write his, and it was so sad, like a whole thing, and then at Gus's funeral, Hazel's favorite author, like, comes to the funeral, and she's all mad at him for being mean to them
mm-hmm.
when they were on their trip. So, but then the author gives her this like envelope and it has a eulogy for Hazel, like for Hazel's funeral, written by Gus.
And
he
gave
like,
it to the author, like
to
sent
like,
it
yeah.
to give to her because he knew he was gonna die before her.
Well, he wanted the author to like help him write it. So yeah, it was so sad because it shows her like reading it. So sad.
Yes.
But yeah. Anyway, back to serial killers, I guess.
Jeffrey Dahmer?
Your favorite serial killer?
Like the most interesting?
Have you ever heard of the Watts family?
With Chris Watts. Yeah.
Wait, I think so.
He killed his wife and his children. He had two daughters. He killed them. his daughters, he worked at an oil company, and he was out on an oil rig, and he wrapped his daughters in their blankets and shoved them into the oil tank.
Yeah, I watched
they
like,
drowned
the documentary on that.
That's how I watched it, too.
It was
and
like,
he buried his wife. He did this because he was cheating on her. He was cheating on his wife. And they think that he did it because he wanted to start a new family and all this stuff. But he's actually, her friend, the wife that he killed, her friend was out with her the night before and called her the next day because she didn't show up to a doctor's appointment because she was pregnant. He killed his pregnant wife.
So he killed four people.
He killed four people.
I watched that documentary.
Mm-hmm.
I listened to... interesting. I watch it while I'm cleaning my room and stuff. Listen to it. I listen to it while I clean my room.
Because it's a podcast?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, anything else?
Okay, well, thank you for watching. We'll see you next time. And have a great, great, great rest of your day. This is a little weird.
I don't think my other video got any views.